Monoclonal antibodies are a synthetic or laboratory-made version of antibodies against the coronavirus. They actually attack the spike protein and inhibit the entry of the virus into the cell. So monoclonal antibodies are given for patients who are diagnosed with COVID but have mild to moderate disease and are at high risk for progression. And so anyone 12 or older that's at high risk for progression, and that would include people who are overweight or obese, people with diabetes, chronic kidney disease, heart disease, lung disease, those who are immunosuppressed, and people who have other complex medical conditions, and people over 65 for sure. Those are all at high risk for progression, and so they can all be candidates for monoclonal antibodies. People should contact their doctor, their doctor can evaluate them and be able to decide if they're a candidate for therapy and then refer them to an infusion center, because these need to be infused by an IV infusion. It is possible to give it subcutaneously now, but that's more difficult and not usually done, and so it's usually done by an IV infusion. So it has to be done at a special infusion center, because these are people who have COVID and are contagious, so it needs to be done at a designated infusion center. Well, yes, they are effective, and they currently are under an emergency use authorization, an EUA, so they're not FDA approved at this point, but we do know that they're effective and they decrease your risk of progressing to COVID to severe COVID disease by about 70%. It needs to be given as soon as feasible after you're diagnosed, but at least within 10 days of the diagnosis. It's not for people who are hospitalized with COVID or who are on oxygen therapy with COVID, because it can actually make those people worse. So it has to be given early in the course of disease. Yes, you can still get this therapy if you are fully vaccinated, but you do need to be in that category of somebody who's got mild to moderate disease and at severe risk of progression. And then another question comes up, like, if you have this antibody, can you get vaccinated? And yes, you still can get vaccinated. We recommend waiting for a period of time, because these antibodies, it shows that they're protective for about 3 months or 90 days. So we think it's best to wait to get your vaccine after that time so that this antibody doesn't compete with the vaccine response. The main thing to realize is that still the best protection against progressing to severe disease is getting the vaccine and getting those two doses. That's still our best protection against severe disease and against hospitalization and death.